Zuhur. Dan insyaAllah ta'ala kita akan meneruskan pengajian kita di dalam kitab Bulughul Maram karangan Al-Imam Ibn Hajar Al-Asqalani, yang mana kita masih berada dalam bab salat jamaah. Dan kita telah sampai ini kepada hadis yang ke-18. Penulis ini mengatakan, wa an Abi Hurairah radhiyallahu anhu qala Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, khairu shufufi rijali awwaluha wa sharruha akhiruha, wa khairu shufufi nisa'i akhiruha wa sharruha awwaluha. Rawahu Muslim. Hadis ini diriwayatkan oleh Abu Hurairah radhiyallahu an, bahwasanya Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam bersabda, sebaik-baik saf lelaki adalah yang pertama. Yani maksudnya di sini, apabila kita melakukan solat jamaah dan kalau ada beberapa saf, misalnya ada 2 saf ataupun 3 saf ataupun 4 saf, maka saf yang paling afdal sekali adalah saf yang pertama. Maka ini adalah yang paling afdal yang dibagi lelaki. Jadi apabila kita melakukan solat jamaah misalnya di Masjid Khalid, maka yang paling afdal sekali adalah kita berdiri pada saf yang ini yang pertama. Maka Nabi mengatakan ini adalah sebaik-baik saf bagi lelaki. Wa syarruha akhiruha. Dan yang kurang sekali adalah yang belakang sekali. Yang saf yang paling depan mengandungi pahala yang lebih besar dibandingkan dengan saf yang paling belakang. Selepas itu beliau mengatakan, wa khayru shufufin nisa'i akhiruha wa sharruha awwaluha. Dan sebaik-baik saf bagi wanita adalah yang terakhir. Jadi kalau sekiranya kita melakukan solat jamaah dan ada lelaki dan ada wanita, sebaik-baik saf bagi lelaki adalah yang paling depan. Alhamdulillah. Sebaik-baik saf ini bagi lelaki adalah yang paling pertama. Kalau dibandingkan dengan akhir ini saf bagi lelaki. Manakala bagi jemaah wanita, sebaik-baik saf adalah yang paling belakang. Terbalik. Bagi lelaki sebaik-baik saf adalah yang paling depan. Manakala bagi wanita sebaik-baik saf adalah yang paling ini belakang sekali. Ini adalah kalau sekiranya dalam jamaah itu kita ada lelaki dan wanita. Yang ini maksudnya wanita berada di belakang lelaki. Kalau sekiranya kita ada jemaah wanita berada di belakang lelaki, maka saf yang paling afdal baginya adalah saf yang paling belakang sekali. Tapi kalau sekiranya jemaah wanita sahaja, maksudnya wanita yang menjadi imam jemaah juga adalah wanita, maka sebaik-baik saf adalah yang pertama. Jadi hadis ini menggambarkan kepada kita, kalau sekiranya dalam jemaah ada lelaki dan wanita, yani maksudnya kita ada jemaah lelaki berada di depan dan kita ada jemaah wanita berada di belakang, maka yang paling afdal bagi lelaki adalah yang paling depan, bagi afdal bagi wanita adalah yang paling belakang. Tapi kalau sekiranya wanita melakukan salat bersama mereka, maka dia sama seperti lelaki. Maksudnya yang paling afdal adalah saf yang paling depan dibandingkan ini dengan saf ini yang paling belakang. Maka hadis ini mengajarkan kepada kita bahawasanya berdiri di dalam saf ada kelebihannya. Saf yang ini yang pertama mendapatkan lebih pahala daripada saf yang ini yang berada yang ini di belakang. Mudah-mudahan Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala memberikan kepada kita taufik insya-Allah. Hadis ini diriwayatkan oleh Al-Imam Muslim. Hadis yang seterusnya berkata penulis, wa an Ibni Abbas radhiyallahu anhu qala, sallaitu ma'a Rasulillah sallallahu alaihi wasallam dhata lailatin faqumtu an yasarihi فأخذ رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم برأسي من ورائي فجعلني عن يمينه. متفق عليه. Hadis ini diriwayatkan oleh Abdullah bin Abbas radhiyallahu anhuma. Dan Abdullah bin Abbas ini seperti mana kita mengetahui, pada zaman Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam beliau masih kecil. Apabila Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam wafat, umur beliau 13 tahun. Umur beliau 13 tahun. You understand? No? You want me to speak English? Better. This is a hadith any on the virtues any of praying in jama'ah. So this hadith any is narrated by Abdullah bin Abbas. Abdullah bin Abbas radiyallahu anhuma. Abdullah bin Abbas, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away, he was 13 years old. 13. Yani small boy. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made dua for him. There was once the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went out and he from the toilet. And then he saw any pail of water. And he asked, who is the person any who brought this water? So the Sahaba say, it is Ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhuma. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made dua, Allahumma faqihhu fid din wa 'allimhu ta'wil. Oh Allah, bless him with the understanding of deen and give him any the ability to do ta'wil, yani to interpret the Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered the dua of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he was the teacher of the Sahaba after the death of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the teacher of the Tabi'in. So he was given the title Turjumanul Quran, Hibrul Ummah, and it is the title of Ibn Abbas. He is called as Turjumanul Quran, and the Mufassir of the Quranul Karim. But he was a small boy when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away. There are many Sahaba who are adults, but because any of the barakah of the doa of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him any with the understanding any of deen, and he is any one of the greatest any mufassir amongst any the sahaba radiyallahu anhu. So he narrated any this particular hadith. He said, qala sallaitu ma'a rasulillahi sallallahu alaihi wasallam dhata laylatin faqumtu an yasarihi. Yani he said that I was praying with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam one night, and Abdullah bin Abbas, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam married to his auntie Maimuna. So one of the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the auntie of Ibn Abbas. So when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam stayed in the house of Maimuna, Abdullah bin Abbas and he stayed and with him. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did qiyamul layl in the house of Maimuna. So Abdullah bin Abbas, and when he was a small boy, he used to pray behind the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this is night prayer, tahajjud prayer. So he prayed on the left side of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is why he said faqumtu an yasarihi. I prayed yani on the left side of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yani meaning the Prophet yani is the imam, he prayed yani on the left side. So what happened yani after that? He said fa akhadha Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam bi ra'si min wara'i fa ja'alani an yaminihi. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used his left hand like this, yani he was praying left. So the Prophet, he said fa akhadha Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam bi ra'si. Yani he used his hand and he pulled the head of Abdullah bin Abbas and he bring him to the right side. Bring to the right side. Because he was praying on the left side. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam brought him and to the right side. This is what he said. فَأَخَذَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمْ بِرَأْسِي مِنْ وَرَائِي فَجَعَلَنِي عَنْ يَمِينِهِ. And until he make me any on the right side. So this particular hadith is narrated by Imam Bukhari and Muslim. And Al-Imam Ibn Hajar said this hadith is muttafaqun alayh. Hadith muttafaqun alayh meaning it is narrated by two imam. Number one is Imam Al-Bukhari, Muhammad bin Ismail Al-Bukhari. Number two is Al-Imam Muslim, Al-Naisaburi. So usually when you have hadith muttafaqun alayh, meaning the authenticity any of this particular hadith is very high in comparison any to other hadith, because Bukhari and Muslim is considered to be the highest books of hadith after the Quran al-Karim. So from this particular hadith, what we can benefit is that when we are praying jama'ah, two person praying in jama'ah, it is a sunnah that the ma'mum stand on the right side of the imam, not on the left side any of the imam. So this particular hadith and it teach us that when two person any is praying, it is not any a sunnah that the ma'mum behind the imam, but the ma'mum any must be near the imam on the right side if there is a man and a man. But if there is any a lady any will be any at the back. So the man any must stay any on the right side. This is any the sunnah any in jama'ah prayers. Sometimes any we find some people make this mistake. And you go into the masjid and you see jama'ah finish, and then there are two person praying, for example. The imam is praying, the ma'mum stand behind the imam. This is not correct. So if you see any a person is praying and you want to become the ma'mum, where should you stand? You should stand any on the right side, any not on the left side and not behind. You must be close any to the imam. Sometimes any when you are praying, the third person come, third person in Urdu is what? Ek, do, tin. Yani tin person come. Third person any come, what must he do now? So now when he see any imam, ma'mum, two person. Imam any is in front, ma'mum on the right side. So this third person comes, what must you do? Yani what you need to do yani is to stand behind any the imam and to pull the ma'mum. You have to pull the ma'mum. So when you pull any the ma'mum must go back two step. And then both yani the ma'mum must stand behind the imam. So if two person, imam is there, ma'mum two person, both any must stand behind the imam. But when the third ma'mum any comes and pull any the first ma'mum, and he pull any the first ma'mum, second ma'mum comes and pull the first ma'mum, the first ma'mum must be careful. Because in prayers any you cannot move a lot. How you go back? The way any is like this. You take two steps any at a time. One, two, stop. One, two, stop. Some people they are in there. The third ma'mum when he comes, they 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All this mushkilah, this problem. Huh? This will make any your prayer any become invalid. So it should not be more than three movement. 1, 2, stop. 1, 2, stop. Then the second ma'mum stays any together with the first ma'mum. So this is basically, if you are praying any in jama'ah, and the third person then he comes any into the jama'ah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with tawfiq insha'Allah. We read one more hadith. An Anas radiyallahu anhu qal. This particular hadith is narrated by Anas. Anas bin Malik. Anas bin Malik is another sahabi who is also small. Small sahabi. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam migrated to Medina, he stayed with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the house of Abu Ayyub al-Ansari. And Anas ibn Malik, he served the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam khidmat. For how many years? For 10 years. That's why Anas ibn Malik, and before he passed away, and he used to say, and he used to be proud. He said, I served the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for 10 years. How many years? 10 years. Khidmat. Ashara sanawat. I khidmat to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and not a single time the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam scolded me. And Anas bin Malik and he said that I served the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and for 10 years. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was in Medina for 10 years. He migrated from Makkah to Medina, and he passed away in Medina for 10 years and he stayed in Medina. And Anas bin Malik is the one and who carried the sandal of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and also the siwak of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So he said that for 10 years I served the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the Prophet never scolded me. And the Prophet never asked me why you do a particular thing. Not even a question asked by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this particular sahabi also, the Prophet made dua for him for barakah. That Allah bless him barakah in his wealth, in his children, in his family. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless Anas ibn Malik with long life. And he has no sickness, healthy person. And he has many children and many wealth. So this particular sahabi, and he is one any of the sahabi who are the last sayyidi to pass away among sayyidi the sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam radiyallahu anhu. So he says, Salla Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam faqumtu wa yateemun khalfahu wa ummu sulaymin khalfana, muttafaqun alayhi wa lafzu lil Bukhari. Yani he said the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam prayed, faqumtu wa yateemun khalfahu wa ummu sulaym khalfana. So now when he say, I prayed with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I stand behind the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam wa yatim. Yatim, yani small boy. Any yatim, any in Islam, any is a person who lost one of his fathers or mother. And he has not reached puberty, baligh. So meaning any a small boy. So he and Anas stood any behind the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam wa ummu sulaym khalfana. Ummu sulaym, what a sahabiya, yani woman. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he taught us, said if you have a man imam and then children or men become sayyidi the ma'mum, they should stand behind the imam. And then if there is a lady, the lady must stand behind the lady, and he must stand behind the man. This is how any we pray in jama'ah. It is not any a sunnah that the lady stand beside the man, even if they are brothers and sisters. But it is a sunnah yani that the lady stand any behind any the man and who are ma'mum. This particular hadith and is also narrated by Al-Imam Bukhari and Imam Muslim and Ibn Hajar, and he mentioned wallafdu lil Bukhari. Yani the words are narrated any by Al-Imam and Bukhari. So inshallah ta'ala we stop any here and we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us any with taufiq and hidayah, and make this majlis of barakah, that Allah bless us and with forgiveness, and Allah answer our prayers, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us and with health, and bless us and with goodness in dunya and akhirah. We have a question, Yaji. Yeah, the correct way is this. Now any you have any the imam, ma'mum any praying any beside, on the right side. So now any the third person comes. The third person, before any he pulls any the first ma'mum, he has to enter into prayer first. Yani he make the takbir. Allahu Akbar, and he enters any into prayer, then he pulls any the imam. Because why, inshallah, this hadith is coming. Next week, inshallah, we speak about this particular hadith. That the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tell us not to pray one person behind the imam. It is makruh in our madhab. Yani to pray one person behind the imam. Al-Imam Ahmad, and he mentioned the prayer becomes invalid. And if a ma'mum prays alone behind the imam, the prayer becomes invalid. So to avoid in this particular situation, it is a sunnah for the ma'mum to enter into prayer first. Then he pull the first ma'mum. Then the ma'mum and he move back into with the imam. So the correct way is to enter into prayer first. Enter into prayer and then pull any the first ma'mum. But nowadays, not many people are doing this. Nowadays, and you find people and enter and into the mosque, masjid, they see two person and praying straight away. He haven't any enter into prayers and he go and pull. This is not correct. Yani you need to enter into prayer first and then you pull. Because if you do it, then inshallah, both of you yani will be in the correct any place in jama'ah. Wallahu a'lam. Boleh aja ya? So inshallah ini bagi saya ini surah Al-Fatihah ila hadrat Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Al-Fatihah. Bismillah.